watching the New Year special edition of Money, Money, Money. We've taken you out of the studios this week to visit one of the largest mutual fund houses in India. We are here at Reliance Mutual Fund. You've just heard their equity outlook for 2019, the kind of funds you can look at. It is now time to talk fixed income, which is why I have with me Amit Tripathi, the CIO Fixed Income at Reliance Mutual Fund. Very happy New Year, first of all, to you.
Thanks,
Amit. Season's greetings.
Best wishes for 2019.
And thank you very much. And the question really is that your market has hogged all the headlines of 2018, from the INFS crisis to what was happening with NBFCs to, you know, whether there's any risk involved in debt mutual funds. What would you say are the learnings for retail investors, and what's the first message you'd like to give to people who want to park money in your funds?
So I think the first message is for the debt markets as a whole, which is that we have definitely turned the corner in September. And we are definitely looking at a much better 2019 than 2018.
Okay.
Having said that, especially when it comes to retail investors, most of whom were looking at investment horizons of 1 year to 3 years and sometimes beyond that, stick to a particular philosophy as far as your investments are concerned.
Sure.
Stick to people and schemes that you are comfortable with.
Sure.
Because ultimately returns can move up and down, but you need to be very, very comfortable with your investments.
Absolutely.
And once you stick to a particular kind of a framework in terms of your decision making, choose those fund houses which are true to label in terms of positioning.
Okay, fair enough. So those are some of the starting points. Please do keep this in mind. You will have to ask questions when you are investing in fixed income funds. You'll have to know the difference between accrual and duration. Basically, are you going to go for a fund which is a play on interest rates and how that cycle is going to sort of evolve? Or will you simply look at a fund which offers you high yields, maybe more than the average fixed deposits? So, you know, before I get into the strategy or what one should do, I must ask you this question because of the headlines of 2018, right? In between, there was also some concern about the kind of entities in which you know, money is being ultimately parked in, whether it's NBFCs, whether these NBFCs in turn lend to real estate, whether you know, certain top promoters of the country, whether some of their funding is happening through the mutual fund route. It's all legitimate, it's all legal, we're saying that, but nonetheless, these are questions that came up.
Yeah.
So as a fixed income manager, how do you answer these?
So at the end of the day, NBFCs are intermediaries like banks, right? As banks do onward lending when they collect money from depositors, NBFCs also do onward lending when they collect money from the wholesale markets. So while the source of funding might be different, retail or wholesale, ultimately it's onward lending for both of the entities. To the extent NBFCs have done lending based on fair practices and in terms of a proper risk management framework, whether it is a retail NBFC, whether it is a wholesale NBFC, whether it is a housing finance company, ultimately for me as a credit guy, when I am looking at any NBFC, I do a very bottom-up kind of a analysis and see that irrespective of which asset class that NBFC typically is lending to, are they doing a good job out of that or not?
Sure. So, since you mentioned housing finance companies, and that became a bit of a bad word towards the end of 2018, have you changed your stance? Are you not investing in securities that are issued by some of these entities, or are you still taking a holistic view? I mean, are there any specific sectors that, let's say, you're staying away from, a certain type of entities that you're staying away from after the INFS episode?
So first of all, if I were to just step back and look at credit as an overall piece, I think credit as an overall piece is always about bottoms-up approach. It is never about taking a sectoral approach or taking a sub-sectoral approach saying housing finance is bad, construction is bad, etc., etc. It is always about a entity and how that is carrying on its business. Okay. Coming specifically to housing finance, the issue was not with regards to the retail piece of their business. Any which ways, mortgage is still regarded as the most valuable underlying security against which you can lend, right? So it is not the retail piece. It's the wholesale piece or wholesale part of their balance sheet, which was being more focused in terms of what the market was focusing on. And I guess as long as one gets the overall comfort that both in terms of allocation, retail is still a predominant part of housing finance companies' balance sheets. And second, the wholesale either is predominantly cash flow backed, as in commercial properties in a LRD format, or the general underwriting standards of that wholesale is very good, which again is a very bottom-up approach when it comes to entity to entity. I think we would be very happy to look at these entities and keep on lending.
Okay. Fair enough.
As long as we have the overall comfort in terms of risk management practices, the way the business is carried out, I think mortgage still remains one of the best asset classes to lend against in India.
Okay, having taken that point on board, let's come down to the advice for 2019 and beyond. And again, we're talking strictly retail investors who have just started moving away from, you know, fixed deposits, and they're still understanding the nuances of fixed income funds. Now, if someone wants to park money for, let's say, 3 years, because that's where the tax advantage kicks in, that's where your benefit of indexation comes in, then what would you say? Duration funds, they play on bonds, but interest rates have gone all over the place from 8% plus to now we are, you know, sub 7.5%. And then there's credit risk. So how would you sort of advise on this?
So see, our overall view on rates is reasonably positive for 2019.
Okay.
We are in some kind of a sweet spot as far as the broader macro is concerned, and everything has been moving in the right direction, so to say, as far as, you know, interest rates are concerned. Having said that, if one is looking at a 3 year plus kind of time horizon, and we are talking about retail investors who may not have too much of appetite for, you know, day to day kind of a volatility.
Absolutely, yeah.
The simplest products to look at are the neutral duration products in fixed income. When I say neutral duration, I'm essentially talking about products that have a two and a half-ish year kind of a duration profile.
Okay.
Short-term bond funds, if you're looking at high-grade products, which is typically AAA oriented, or accrual or credit funds, if you're looking at high-yield funds. So while I, as a portfolio manager or as a risk guy, will always tell you that I'm very comfortable with my you know, credit risk fund.
Sure.
I think
is that where you would park your money as well?
I already have parked my money in my credit risk fund.
Anyway, we are back here with the other gentleman from Reliance Mutual Fund as well. It's been a pleasure. But before I let all of you all go, we must do like one quick rapid fire, like really quick one. So, your favorite fund out of your own universe where you'd park, let's say, the maximum amount of your money next year?
Multicap.
The Reliance Multicap.
Yeah.
Sandeep, for you?
Reliance Banking Fund.
The Banking Fund. And okay, Amit's already mentioned his one, so, you know, I get that. But if we overall talk about resolutions, you started off with a very politically correct answer. Now, let's talk about real resolutions. So, 2019 for you?
Health.
Health.
Lose weight.
Okay, lose weight. Oh my God, I think I've had that every single year. Let's not even bother now. Sandeep, for you?
Of course, first is lose weight. Every year I take this resolution.
What's
but
the point? Message.
But I think the next thing is not only make pin shape yourself, take care of your finances also. For that,
yes.
I think keep looking at money.
Oh, brilliant. Yes, that's good advice. And what's your resolution of it?
I guess more delegation. Let my team work harder and let me take more rest.
This is excellent. I think I'm coming off with some great ideas at the end of this conversation. Gentlemen, thank you very much. Wish you a very pleasant, happy, prosperous and healthy 2019. And we will touch base with you through the course of the year and we'll see how wealth generation comes along.
Thank you very much.
Also, very, very happy new year.
All right. And with that, it's a wrap at the Reliance Mutual Fund headquarters here. This first edition of Money in 2019. We again wish you a very healthy, very prosperous and a very, very nice new year. We will keep coming to you throughout the course of the year with more ideas and more ways of making your money work for you. Keep watching.